and welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on interconverting masses, moles, and numbers of particles. 1 mole is equal to 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. And this number is referred to as Avogadro's number. And Avogadro's number was determined by measuring the number of carbon atoms in exactly 12 grams of the isotope carbon-12. And so Avogadro's number is a rather large number. And the concept of Avogadro's number and the mole are often concepts that are only talked about in chemistry. But the thing is, the concept of a mole is similar to the concept of, say, a dozen. So for example, if you have 1 dozen pencils, you have 12 pencils. Or if you have 1 dozen cookies, you have 12 cookies. A dozen could also be applied to some more typical chemistry terms. If you have 1 dozen atoms, you have 12 atoms. Or if you have 1 dozen molecules, you have 12 molecules. And the application of a mole is the same. So you could have a mole of pencils, and if you had a mole of pencils, you would have 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd pencils. If you had a mole of cookies, you would have 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd cookies. But more commonly, we talk about moles in relation to atoms or molecules. Now, we don't often talk about having a mole of pencils or a mole of cookies, because that's such an extreme amount of everyday objects. We talk about moles more in relation to atoms or molecules. By definition, 1 atom of carbon-12 is equal to exactly 12 AMU, or atomic mass units. And so 1 mole of carbon-12 is equal to exactly 12 grams. And so the weight of 1 atom or molecule in atomic mass units is equal to 1 mole of that same atom or molecule in grams. And so this is an extension of the concept of formula weight. And we call the weight of 1 mole of an element or molecule its molar mass. So using this information, we can now convert between grams and moles. And we do that using the molar mass. We also know that we can convert between moles and atoms or molecules using Avogadro's number. What this slide also illustrates is that although you can go indirectly from grams to atoms or molecules, you cannot directly go from grams to atoms or molecules. You need to go through moles to convert between grams and molecules. Let's try an example. How many atoms of cadmium are in 2.5 moles of cadmium? So we'll start with 2.5 moles of cadmium. We know that if we want to go from moles to atoms or molecules, we need to use Avogadro's number. So 1 mole of cadmium is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd atoms of cadmium. And we put moles of cadmium on the bottom so that moles will cancel out. This tells us that in 2.5 moles of cadmium, there are 1.51 times 10 to the 24th atoms of cadmium. Let's try a slightly more complicated example. 68.3 grams of potassium hydroxide are equal to how many molecules of potassium hydroxide? So we start with 68.3 grams of potassium hydroxide. And we know that we can't go directly from grams to molecules. So our first step needs to be to convert from grams of potassium hydroxide to moles of potassium hydroxide. And we do that using the molar mass. So 1 mole of potassium hydroxide is equal to 56.1 grams of potassium hydroxide. So remember, the numerical value of the molar mass in grams is equal to the numerical value of the formula weight in AMU. So if you know how to calculate formula weights for compounds, you know how to calculate the molar masses of compounds. By putting grams of potassium hydroxide on the bottom, this allows us to cancel out grams of potassium hydroxide. Now we can convert from moles to molecules using Avogadro's number. So 1 mole of potassium hydroxide is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of potassium hydroxide. Again, we placed moles of potassium hydroxide on the bottom, so it will cancel with moles of potassium hydroxide on the top. Now, remember when writing out these conversions, not to confuse moles with molecules. Sometimes people start abbreviating molecules, MOL, and that's going to make it harder to keep your units straight in your dimensional analysis problems. We can then cancel out moles of potassium hydroxide, and we're left with molecules of potassium hydroxide. So our calculation tells us that 68.3 grams of KOH is equal to 7.33 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of KOH. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.